So now we are going to sniff data from our Raspberry Pi device. As you can see on the top right of the screen, Raspberry Pi is connected without any monitor or keyboard, and we are going to connect Raspberry Pi through VNC, right? As we did before during the installation, right? So it's only connected right now with my adapters, right? So Raspberry Pi is connected to the same network as this device, right? The device which I am using as my laptop, right? So let's just try to connect to our Raspberry Pi device. So we need to know the IP of Raspberry Pi, right? So there are multiple methods. I'm going to show you one of them, which is using Angry IP. So let's just open Angry IP. It's basically advanced IP scanner. Sorry, it's not Angry IP. So you can use any of the tool, or you can directly go into the access point if you have the access to it, or you can use any of the advanced IP scanner tool. Let me run it. And over here you have to put the range of your network, right? So I have put in my network range, you have to put your own. So let's just start scan. It will take around few seconds to scan the complete network. So as you can see, we are getting the live devices connected to the same network. So as you can see, we have found the IP of Raspberry Pi over here. As you can see, its IP is 192.168.25.104, right? So we are going to connect to Raspberry Pi through this IP using VNC, right? So as you can see on the top right, it has nothing, and there is no wire attached to Raspberry Pi. We are going to connect directly through wireless, right? So let's just close it, and let's just open VNC, and let's just I have all let's just type the IP of the Raspberry Pi device, which is 104, and it will ask us for the password, right? So the password which we have set during the installation, you should remember your password. I'm going to type my own password, right? So it is basically the password of the VNC, right? The password which we set up during the VNC connection, right? So I am just connected with my Raspberry Pi device without any keyboard or mouse, just using VNC. And let's just open terminal for now. And at the top right, as you can see, there are two different wireless adapter attached to the Raspberry Pi. So let's just do ifconfig and see how many wireless adapters we have. So we have basically three wireless adapters. As you can see, WLAN 0, WLAN 1, and WLAN 2. Right? So WLAN 0 and WLAN, as you can see, WLAN 0 and WLAN 1 is connected to the same network, right? And WLAN 2 is not connected to any network, right? We are going to use it in the future. Right now, the two wireless adapters, which is WLAN 0, which is the built-in one in Raspberry Pi 3 and onwards, we are connected with this one, and there are two external Wi-Fi adapters, WLAN 1 and WLAN 2, from which WLAN 1 is also connected with the same network, right? So this is basically the scenario of Raspberry Pi, right? So let's just clear out for a second. So the tool we are going to use for the MITM attack is MITMF, Man in the Middle framework. We have used this tool in the past series as well. So we are going to use the same tool right now. So you can download this tool very easily doing apt get install and MITMF, right? I have already installed this tool and all the dependencies. You have to install this tool. I have shown how to install this tool in the previous video, in the previous series, sorry. So you have to watch that series if you don't know how to install this tool. So I have shown this in my previous series, which is MITM Attack Basic to Advanced. If you haven't watched this series, you have to before starting this series, you have to complete that, right? If you don't know about MITM attacks, right? So let's just start. So let's just do MITMF, the tool name. Then we are going to see, do log, and I'm going to show you why we are doing log, and then dash level and debug. Let's first just do help to see all the options, right? So these are basically the options available in MITM attack, right? So we are going to see few of important ones in this series. I have covered a lot of these in the previous series as well. So we are going to see the important ones, right? So let's just clear out the screen for now. Right. And let's just start the tool, which is MITMF. And then we have to give log with double dash log dash level. And then we have to give space and debug, right? And I'm going to show you why we are doing this in a moment, right? So before starting the ARP spoof, you have to do dash dash log dash level debug, right? So it's going to display all the errors if there are some errors, or all the logs on the screen, right? So let's just type the complete command, which is dash dash ARP dash dash spoof, then double dash gateway, and you have to give the gateway IP, which is basically the router IP. I'm going to give my own. Then double dash targets with S, and then you have to give the target IP, and you should know how we are getting this target IP through information gathering section, right? So 103 is my target IP. And then what I have to do is the single dash and I, which is for interface, I have to type the name of my wireless adapter, right? So there are two wireless adapters connected with the same network, right? I have shown you before. Let's just type ifconfig again and see. So WLAN 1 is connected and WLAN 0 is connected with the same network, right, on which we are going to attack right now. So you can use any of it, but if you are connected with let's suppose I am connected with 104 IP, which is on WLAN 0. So I will use WLAN 1 for my attack, right? So let's just try to do it. Let's just use WLAN 1 and hit enter. So the tool is started now. Okay, so as you can see, it's showing us errors, right? Unable to resolve MAC address of 192.168.25.103, right? So this error might come if you are using multiple adapters on a single device, right? So MITMF might throw this error if you are using multiple wireless adapter like I am doing. So the easiest solution to this is you have to control C, cancel out the attack, right? And all you have to do is disconnect from your VNC adapter on which you are using the VNC connection, like I'm using on WLAN 0. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to close the connection from WLAN 0 and I'm going to make a connection on WLAN 1, right? So the connection for VNC I'm going to make is on WLAN 1, and the attack I'm going to do is from WLAN 0 since WLAN 1 is not working, right? Because of multiple adapters reason, right? So let's just close it. And yes, are you sure you want to disconnect? We can easily disconnect. And let's just type the IP of WLAN 1 and hit enter. You have to again type the password, which is your own password. And again, we are connected from the same position, right? Where we left. So, and over here you can see I have connected with 105 and it's on WLAN 1. Let me show it to you one more time. Let's just do ifconfig, and over here you can see 105 IP is assigned to WLAN 1, right? So let's just close it and let's just do the attack again. So the attack is same, but now we are going to use WLAN 0 as our attacking interface. So it's MITMF double dash log dash dash level debug with a space and no dashes in front of it, then double dash ARP, double dash spoof, then double dash gateway IP, then your target IP, and then the interface, right? So let's just hit enter. So it takes few seconds to start the attack. So the attack is started. Now let's see if it's again showing the error, same error. So let's just give it the second. Okay, it's now resolved the IP and the error is removed, right? So the attack is now successful. If it's showing resolved, that means the attack is successful, right? So let's just start Wireshark as well. We can start Wireshark directly going on applications and sniffing and spoofing tools and Wireshark, right? So we are performing the attack on WLAN 0, right? So let's just start sniffing as well on WLAN 0. So let's just double click it, right? And let's just close the connection, right? So the attack is going on. There will be no effect of closing VNC connection. So let's just close the VNC connection, and let's just suppose that we are closing the connection for an hour or 2 hours or a complete night, right? So let's just close it as well, and let me open my device on which I have performed the attack. So over here you can see the mirror image of my device on which I have performed the attack, and it's connected to the same network as you can see, and you can check out the IP as well over here, right? So the internal IP, as you can see it over here, is 103 on which we have performed the attack, right? So let's just try to do some surfing on it, right? So let's just do a little bit of search as well, and let's just go on the demands page as well, right? And let's just try to fill out this form. Let's just do and let's just hit submit. So the form is submitted, right? So let's just visit some other sites as well. All right, so we have visited two sites, and let's just assume that we can do the surfing on and on, right? So we can visit multiple sites and we can do multiple things, right? So let's just connect to the VNC again, right? And see if we are getting the data or not, right? The attack is still going on, as you can see. So let's just cancel out the attack for now because we have gathered a lot of traffic right now. And in the next video, what I'm going to show you is how you can analyze the SNF file, right? So we will see how we can see the sensitive information and take out the sensitive information out of the captured file, right? So let's just cancel out this attack.